Grapeseed oil. I was inspired to do a quick video on grapeseed oil because it's in my Ultra Moisture. I was researching that product. It works so well for people's under eyes. I wanted to research more about grapeseed oil, so I'm going to tell you a little bit about it, how you can use it in a very simple form. You likely get it at your grocery store if you wish. I'm going to show you a quick study. As I was researching it, some interesting things came up that I didn't know about it. I'm going to share that with you real quickly. But understanding that grapeseed oil is a light oil. It's not like, say, an olive oil or coconut oil that's heavy. And people are often, hey, I don't want to put that on my skin, other than you know who uses the olive oil. But that is a thick, heavy oil. And people often with acne, especially, you're like, I don't want to put oils on my skin. Oils are not only good for your skin, they're important. And I advise people to use them. And of course, I have a lot of oils in my skincare, especially that Ultra Moisture product, which is just that. It's for ultra moisturizing the skin. It's a glass skin step, buffering other active products. But as a standalone, you can use grapeseed oil quite easily at home, and cold pressed is the best way. But let's think first of all what it does. It has a lot of vitamins in it, first of all, A, C, E, and we like those vitamins. It also has free fatty acids, omega-3s like linoleic acid, many of you know about. So it has a lot of components in it that people like, and we're going to see from this quick study we're going to look at. But people do use it for acne, and they find that it works quite well. And part of the reason is it also has antimicrobial effects, wound healing effects. So it does many things, and it does brighten the skin. So if you're finding you have dull skin, oils can really help without causing acne, and a light oil like grapeseed here, that will help give you just kind of a, it will lumify the skin. It gives this luminous look that just wakes it up. And I'll tell you at the end of the video exactly how to apply it, but I did want to show you this study that I came across and just see what it said about grapeseed oil and why maybe it works. Because inflammation leads to aging, and we know there's a lot of antioxidants here. Okay, so this is the article I looked at, went down this rabbit hole. It's from 2018. Anti-inflammatory skin barrier repair effect of topical application of some plant oils. A great article, and a lot here that I think we can extrapolate. Several videos we probably need to do on it. But they talk about plant oils. A couple sections that I want to come back and go through with you are the stratum corneum. It's so important. We talk about it all the time. And wound healing, the wound healing effects of the MMPs, elastase, collagenase, the things that take our extracellular matrix, kill it, and we get SAG. I want to go through that with you at some point. It's a great article. If you're interested, let me know. Today, I wanted to focus on the grapeseed oil in the interest of your time. It's all interesting to me, so I would love to go through it all. Here they talk phenolic compounds that are present and what they do. There are phenolic compounds, of course, in our grapeseed oil. Let's go back up here. They're talking olive oil, and here we are, sunflower and our grapeseed. This is where I wanted to focus today, so let's look at what they're talking about. The grapeseed oil comes from these seeds of Vitis vinifera right here, okay? It's rich, as I said, in phenolic compounds, FFAs, free fatty acids, of course, associated in the barrier of the skin, and very important, free fatty acids. Grapeseed oil has been evaluated for WH activity. WH is wound healing, and you'll know that from all my videos on platelet-rich fiber and blood products, growth factor skincare, all involved in wound healing. They've shown that the hydroxyproline content of granulation tissue was significantly higher in animals treated with the grape oil. Hydroxyproline is involved in the extracellular matrix. That's why that's important. Additionally, the rate of wound closure was also quicker, suggesting their wound healing potential. Very important. Wound healing in our world equates to better skin and factors such as oxygenase species that are associated with wound healing. Very complex, but very important for great skin. The direct topical application of grapeseed oil on human skin has not yet been very well investigated. Very little has been well investigated because it's human skin and there's very few prospective trials on these. So we're extrapolating from historical information and data. Even identical twins, very difficult to study with respect to skincare because they have different phenotypical and environmental exposures, even though they're genetically the same. Grapeseed extract, which contains resveratrol, has been applied to mice showing their faster wound contraction and hit synthesis of vascular endothelial growth factor. VEGF is in my lectures on EZPRF, platelet-rich fibrin gel. Vascular endothelial growth factor is associated with improved skin, with improved blood flow, and therefore improved nutrients to the skin. One of the most studied for skincare is VEGF, along with transforming growth factor is another one. And greater connective tissue deposition. Resveratrol displays a direct antimicrobial activity against pathogens such as, look at this, Staphylococcus and Enterococcus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. We know them in medicine. I know it sounds pretty big and esoteric. Very important ones. Tough pathogens. These are tough, and there's antimicrobial effect on them. So amazing. Topically applied, resveratrol increases cathelicidin production in normal skin. This is one of the inducible antimicrobial peptides and inhibits the growth of Staph aureus. Again, a tough pathogen. Studies are currently being done to successfully encapsulate and preserve resveratrol from the grapeseed oil. So applying the grapeseed oil, you get it, but imagine if you could extract it and make it pure, much like they're doing with nanoparticles of curcumin in my whole video, which you should watch, which is on turmeric, and curcumin is the active part of turmeric. In addition, resveratrol grapeseed oil has a high content of linoleic acid, vitamin E, and phenolic compounds we talked about, very important for great skin. Phenolic compounds, resveratrol, vitamin E, and grapeseed oil provide most of its antioxidant activity. Moreover, phytoesterols present in grapeseed oil may modulate pro-inflammatory mediators. So it modulates them, so it keeps them under control. Chronic inflammation is bad. Grapeseed oil, I absolutely love it. Let's move on. So if you're going to use grapeseed oil, and you, even if you have it in a product that you already have, maybe you want to use it as a standalone. So you're going to use cold pressed, a few drops on the hand, warm it up, apply to the face. You can use it up to twice a day, but in terms of layering, I like it to be the last step. So your actives, like your AHA or your retinoics, they should be first. You're paying more money for them. They're stronger. You want them to be on moist skin or freshly cleansed skin if you want the most effect. If you're getting irritation from them, you could put a moisturizer on first and then your actives. You could also put this oil on first in terms of the grapeseed oil, but it will negate likely much of the effect because it's a larger molecule. It is an oil, and it might really not allow that the retinol or the AHA to get into your skin, but it's worth trying because it could overnight, which is when a lot of people apply the AHAs and the retinols, it might allow slow release of that into your skin. Everyone's going to be a little different, but all skin types can benefit from grapeseed oil. I put a complete playlist up here on things you can do at home and one down here on different skincare products you might try to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.